So we heard from Nationals Deputy Leader Paula Bennett and Jane's story there and her concerns this morning. Just before we came to air, I spoke to Ms. Bennett and asked her if she feels safer now a parliamentary staffer has been stood down.
I do feel better for the staff around here. I'm hoping that there is some relief for them, that they don't think that potentially... I mean, I just think that the Speaker's language this morning was reckless and inflammatory and has caused so much concern around here. There has been genuine staff that think that there is a repeat rapist working amongst them whom they don't know. And so either that is absolute and the Speaker knows that, in which case, in my opinion, police should have been involved to investigate. That does not mean that they are outing victims that don't want to be named, but an investigation started does not necessarily need victims coming forward.
Or but wasn't he hamstrung by that commitment, though? The commitment for anonymity, isn't he hamstrung by that to a certain degree?
I would have thought if you had a pattern of behaviour that has come through, and he is telling us that it was more than three, that surely that would be enough that you would go to police for them to at least look at an investigation. That doesn't mean it might lead to prosecution, but at least it means some questions might have been asked. But to actually, and remember, these women were interviewed weeks, even possibly months ago. So for some of the staff and others here, it is extremely terrifying to think that they have a known, in his words, rapist working amongst them, and they felt so unsafe. And I think that needs, future victims need to be considered as well.
So would you have gone to the police?
Yes.
Did you make any calls to the police today?
No, I didn't. I didn't know enough. I felt, obviously, I could only go by the media reports in the Francis Review. So I went and saw the Speaker, spoke quite passionately to him about it. But, I mean, they knew the name of the alleged perpetrator, not me. So I could hardly say I think there might be someone at Parliament who was, because the Speaker said it on in the media.
So do you now know who this person is, and do you know who the complainant is? Have you talked to any of the people directly involved?
No, I don't.
Just on the subject of going straight to the police when you see a pattern of behaviour, more than three women, serious complaints.
Well, he says rape.
Yeah, he said rape, but the report says sexual assaults, doesn't it? So even at a level of sexual assault, where there is a pattern, you would go to the police. Mm. Or harassment.
A serious sexual assault, they said, yeah.
Yeah. So I'm wondering why in your own party, you chose to keep allegations of harassment within your own party a secret, if that's the position you're now taking now.
We saw nothing like this. Absolutely nothing like this. And to be fair, when we saw a pattern of inappropriate behaviour, we confronted those allegations to the perpetrator and went straight to them. So I have absolutely no qualms in how I handled. We've got someone that's known who a perpetrator might have been working amongst us at the level of rape and hasn't confronted them or gone to police.
So it's a matter of degree, is that what you're saying?
I don't think there's circumstances that are similar, and I have absolute confidence, and I know that I handled what I've had to handle in the past, which is why the today has been so distressing for people that have felt re-traumatised, that have felt scared, and having to work with them with I just think that words that have been thrown out there, either it is rape, and if it's that serious, something needed to be done sooner to ensure the safety of people working around that alleged perpetrator, or it's not that serious, and then we've got real issues, because I think that's caused a real level of unrest and uncertainty.
And I do understand your position on this, but I want to go back to your party and the handling of accusations of harassment, because I'm wondering, in the context of this report, it talks about a culture of silence. Do you think that you and others within your party have added to a culture of silence?
The day I knew about more than one complaint, I took it directly to the person and took action.
Did you go to the police at all during that time?
There is absolutely no way that I have not done enough. I have never had an allegation of rape or anything of that serious nature. I have handled it at the level it should be, while also protecting all victims, which I will do with every inch of what I've got, even if it takes criticism from the media.
Right, so, but you didn't, no one within the party called the police about this. I just want to be clear on that point.
Not it wasn't okay. At that level, Lisa.
Okay, so it is, about...
I will put victims first.
So it is about degrees.
A crime had not been committed.
Right.
A crime has been committed if the speaker's words are true.
So in the...
Actually, one of the most serious crimes, I think, that you can, apart from murder.
The report lists, I think it was, 14 allegations of sexual assault, right? And 11 were against people who are still employed in and around Parliament. One person has been stood down here. Are you convinced that there aren't still predators in your midst?
Well, I can't be. I'm not the one that was listening to it. I don't know who's working here. I don't know who's involved. I just know that we have done everything we can to ensure the safety of our staff, to ensure that they can come forward and talk to us. I don't know the degrees of what the Francis Review have gone out, just would have read like you have, but like any workplace, and particularly one this big, I think we're dealing with some pretty awful issues that we have to take really seriously.
One other thing just before you go, we spoke to Barbara Currigy last night and I asked her if she recognised any of the behaviours in this report. Did you recognise any of the behaviours contained in the report?
I think I've certainly seen, perhaps, I mean, apart from the obvious in the last 12 months, before that I probably have seen people when they're tired at the end of their tether, sometimes in the way they speak to staff or that sort of thing. I don't think I've always seen the best behaviour from everybody all of the time. I kind of agree with the report that it's a very small number of people, and I would argue that most are pretty outstanding and amazing, but I would, I probably have seen some of it that has made me comment before.
If you are completely honest with yourself, is any of this behaviour present in your party?
Not that I see now, no.
And you're convinced of that?
As convinced as I can be. As I say, this is long hours, but there's no excuses. These are people in places that work pretty quickly. I'm not sure everybody is perfect all of the time, but I think that they check their behaviour better than they ever have.
And that's National's Deputy Leader Paula Bennett there. If this story has raised any issues of concern or distress for anyone listening, you can call or text 1737, 1737 on the text anytime to speak to a trained counsellor for any reason, or call Safe to Talk on 0800 044 334 for urgent help. That number again, 0800 044 334. And if it's an emergency and you feel that you or someone else is at risk, call the police, 111.